Hey guys, on this episode of Restore and Protect, we have a 2011 Cadillac CTS. Now, unfortunately, it's not the V edition. That would be much cooler, but my client bought this car at a good price, and I have been tasked with the job to get this thing ready for resale. So on today's episode, you're gonna see me take this dingy CTS and restore it back to its glory. Now, as you can tell, the headlights need some loving. There is a local scratch and shine sticker in the windshield. The wheels are absolutely abysmal. They need some attention. The interior, though, is relatively clean for the vehicle's age. The paint, however, is absolutely destroyed from the local car wash, and just all the jams, the door jams, the trunk jams, the engine bay jams in the engine bay will be getting a full detail as well. So if you're ready for this episode, let's get started. Just finishing up the driver's side headlight, and man, it actually came out really good. I honestly didn't have super high hopes. I'll show you, they looked practically the same. So there's the passenger side, there's the difference. It is a massive difference. But now I'm gonna do the passenger side, and then we'll pull this thing out and get started on the engine bay. All right, now I'm gonna do the engine bay. So I'm gonna get my foam cannon set up. I'm going to mix a little bit of a degreaser into my foam cannon with some of my pre-soak soap. This is a high pH soap, so it'll start breaking down some of that road grime. And I'll normally use the same bucket and tools I do on the wheels in the engine bay, so I'm gonna mix up my wheel bucket with a little bit of wheel and tire cleaner, and then just a little bit of car shampoo to get a little bit more foam. Alrighty, gonna remove the engine cover, maybe. I'm gonna remove this engine cover, put the oil cap back on. Oh, All right, next up, as always, start the exterior detail with wheels and tires. And honestly, these need a wheels off detail, but that's not in the customer budget. So I'm gonna do the best I can with them on. Up next is, you guessed it, the armpits of the vehicle. So all the door jams, the trunk jams, and the gas cap. All right, now that I got the armpits of the car done, I'm going to mix up my pre-soak. And what my pre-soak is a mixture of a high pH soap and a little bit of car shampoo just to give it a little bit more foaming capability. Mix that up. Mix a little bit of my car shampoo in there. Always raise up the wipers if you can. All right, let's get this thing going. All right, guys, the reason why a pre-soak is so important is it starts to break down all the grime and salt and bug guts on the vehicle. So that way, whenever I go and rinse off the pre-soak, I'm getting as much stuff off as I can to reduce the scratching of the vehicle whenever I go to do my contact wash. I'm gonna let it dwell for a couple more minutes, rinse it off, refoam it down, and do my contact wash. All right, now let's get on to the contact wash. All right, next up, I'm going to use a clay bar instead of a clay mitt on this vehicle. If I run my hand across the hood, I could feel little specks of contamination sticking up. So I'm gonna go, I know I'm polishing this vehicle, so I'm gonna go with a clay bar instead of a clay mitt. It's a little bit more aggressive, but does leave some marring behind. So if you're using a clay bar, make sure you're going to be polishing afterward. As you can see, there is quite a bit of contamination that came off of that hood. So I'm gonna go around, do that to the entire vehicle. Alright, just finished up, and that is what came off the back bumper. All right, now that I got the clay bar process done, it is feeling a lot better. Now, I'm gonna spray on my iron remover and get any of the embedded iron particles out of the paint as well. I'm gonna go ahead and do the wheels too because they were pretty bad. I'm gonna let this dwell for a few minutes. It's hard to see on the paint, but you can see it running off of the vehicle, and that's all of the iron contamination coming off of the vehicle. I don't know if you can see it there. So it's definitely there. It's just really hard to see it on a black vehicle. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and spray off this iron remover. Oh yeah, you can just tell when a car has absolutely no protection, no wax, sealant, ceramic on it. It is a menace to dry. Good Lord. This has gotta be one of the worst ones I've felt in a while. All right, if you watched the S2000 video, you know that we are going to take some paint measurements before I do some test spots to see how we're going to attack this paint. Before I do that though, I wanted to shout out Brent from Encore. I got that hat, buddy. Thank you so much for sending it. I'm gonna wear it all the time. If you've never watched any of Brent's content and you're into window tinting and PPF, I will link his channel down below. Go check Brent out. He puts out some amazing content on window tinting and PPF. But same as before, I'm going to go around. My app gives me points on the hood that I'm going to measure and get the thickness, and then that will give me a better plan of how I'm going to correct this paint. Everything is in the green, so that's good. This car has not been repainted or has had any body work done. It's also a good thing. I'm sure the current owner will be happy about that one. All right, and of course, right before I have to leave to go to a car show, the mail shows up. I just finished up the interior, but I have been waiting to try out the CarPro Ultra Cut. I'm really excited. I've heard really good things about it. I wish I could try it out today, but I don't feel like getting a pad out and then making a pad dirty and have to clean it and use it tomorrow. So I'm just gonna wait until tomorrow where I can finish the exterior of the car before I try it. But man, super excited, heard good stuff. Cannot wait to try it. All right, I'm gonna do a test spot here on the hood with the CarPro Ultra Cut. We'll see how it does. Super easy to wipe off. That is awesome. Obviously this paint's not gonna be perfect. It has a lot of imperfections in it, but looks like somebody has maybe tried some rocket repairs. And for a single step, it is not bad. There's still a lot of imperfections in the paint, but you have to take in customer expectations and customer budget into factor. It's not worth for this vehicle to get too crazy with the paint correction when the customer is not sure if they're gonna keep it and the total value of the vehicle is not that much. That's gonna do just fine for today. And also, there's been a lot of, looks like somebody has tried to touch up a lot of rock chips on here and did not do a great job. So it's not gonna be perfect by any means, but it's gonna be a lot better. We'll be right back. And I don't know if you can see the difference on camera or not, but in person, there's a very distinct difference between the two sides. This side almost looks like a dark gray now compared to black. It's crazy what a little bit of paint enhancement can do. Alright, we got the CTS done with the one-step enhancement. It definitely added some depth and gloss to this black paint, but to be honest with you, this vehicle really needed a heavy cut with probably a rotary to get it perfect, but we weren't going for perfect on this particular vehicle. You always have to work within the budget. And the overall value of the vehicle really wasn't worth it. And it might be going up for sale, so the owner may not even have this vehicle for much longer. So we opted with just the enhancement to try to bring out some gloss and depth and clean up the paint. This paint was horrendous. It was awful. But that's what years and years of going through a car wash will do. But we got her cleaned up, and now I'm going to apply my 1 year ceramic coating on the entire vehicle and get this thing protected. One nice thing about this ceramic coating is it has a super long flash time. So I'm able to coat like half the vehicle almost before I gotta start wiping. That definitely makes the installation process go quicker. Now this CTS, as much as I would love to make it perfect, it just wasn't in the budget and it didn't make sense to make the paint perfect on this. Just the price of the vehicle and the age, it's just really not worth the owner putting that much money into, especially if they may resell it. So what we did was a paint enhancement, I would call it. Brought back a lot of depth and shine in the paint, and that's what's gonna really pop whenever the future buyer sees it. We did an engine bay detail, full interior detail, and we topped it with my 1 year ceramic coating. This paint is not perfect. If you get it underneath a light, you know, if you're a detailer and you're watching, black GM paint is very difficult. And it just wasn't in the budget to go any further with it, but it looks amazing outside. With the miles on the car and the value of the car, I think it looks fantastic. And I know the owner is gonna be really happy with it. It started raining just long enough when I got home from the gym to pull the vehicle out, get some pictures of it. So that was nice. The customers are on their way to pick it up, and I can't wait for them to see it. But thank y'all so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more content like this in the future. I have several vehicles lined up here to do videos on. A wide range of vehicles, there's some trucks, SUVs, cars. So we're gonna get the ball rolling on some YouTube videos. I can't wait to share with you guys the stuff that I love to do. So hopefully y'all will enjoy it as well. But that's gonna do it for this episode of Restore and Protect.